Hello and welcome to the second part of the How to Create a Ring in uMake tutorial series. My name is Nico, and in this section of the tutorial, we are going to basically take this curve that we drew, this profile curve here, and create a revolved surface around it and then start adding some details to the ring. So to jump in, I've edited this curve to be essentially what I want it to be, and now I'm going to double tap and select it and then mirror it over the x-axis like that. And I need to make this one single curve. So to do that, I'm going to select both of these curves, go to Edit, and up here, I'm going to merge this point. And then down here, I'm going to connect these two points. Let's see, hold on. Select both of these and tap Connect. And then I need to merge this one again. And now we have we should have one curve. There we go. All right, now there's a surface here. We don't really need that surface, but I'm gonna leave it for the moment. Now I'm gonna select this curve. This is one single curve. And at this point, I am going to go to the front view and then tap revolve. And what I wanna do is bring this axis down. Actually, it needed to be in the side view, but that's okay. Bring this axis down here and get it as close to the origin axis as I can by moving these little handles. And there we go. We now have a nice ring element. Looks pretty nice. And we have the gemstone at the top. So this kind of concave shape here and a nice flat inner surface. Once I'm done with that revolved surface, I'm gonna tap the green check mark, just like that. And let's spice things up right away. Let's select the surface and make it silver or gold. I'll try what silver looks like, and we'll see what gold looks like. I think I'm gonna go with a silver for now. There we go. So there is nice silver ring, and we have a gemstone here. Now I'm going to select this gemstone. It's already grouped. And what I want to do here is I'm going to actually make an array of it. So I'm going to go back to the front view and I'm going to tap array. And I'm going to bring this green array point down here. It should usually snap. I think it's not, because when there was a circle here, I'm going to go back for a second. That circle that we initially drew got split when I drew that curve. Now, if that happens, if that circle gets split, then, essentially what happens is the array part won't exactly center. And that's okay, because I'm just gonna make a copy of this circle and scale it down just a little bit. And you can see that it did indeed get split here. That's okay. We'll just draw another circle. We just need a circle. And then we're going to center this by using snap to grid. Oh, copy still on. We're going to center this using snap to grid. So there we go, that's snapped. We're not going to need this after we use the array, but it's good to have. You'll see why in just a second. So let's go back and select this gemstone again. And then what we're going to do is tap array, and if we bring this little green point down, you'll see it'll snap right to the middle of the circle, or in this case, right to the grid. We have 5 copies. I'm going to turn on 12. There we go. There's 12. Could probably go for 14. Yeah, let's go with 14 for now. There we go. So you can see that these are in the ring. See what 16 looks like just to see. Actually, we'll go with 16. So there's 16. And once I'm done, I'm gonna tap the green check mark again. We have 16 gemstones. And what I want is I want these gemstones to be pretty much all over the whole ring. So the whole ring just embedded with gemstones. I'm gonna go through and select each one. There we go. So we have all of them selected. It looked like when I selected an initial group, I accidentally moved some. So let's go back and let's try that again. Try not to move them when you select them. The other thing that I could do, actually, that would be a lot faster, is I will just select this revolved surface and this curve and this surface here and this curve. And I'm going to go to my layers, add new layer, assign these to the layer, and I can just hide that for now. There we go. Don't need this, so I'll erase this surface there. And now I'm just going to select all of these, just like that. That's a lot easier, as you can see. So I have all of those selected. I don't need this circle selected, so I'll double tap to deselect that. And now I just have the gemstone selected. Now what I want to do is I want to group this, and then I'm going to make another array. And you can see it goes a little crazy there. That's because we have five copies on. Now I just need two copies, and then I'm going to change the angle and just try and get these in the middle like that. That looks about right. That looks pretty good. Once I'm done, I'll tap the green check mark. And now we have a whole set of gemstones nicely and evenly spaced. Go back and turn the ring on. Get rid of this center element. And just like that, you have a nice ring with gemstones that go all the way around it. Now you can try doing various things. You can put little posts around the diamonds and add some embellishments and use array. But basically what I wanted to show you how to do was create a profile curve, use the revolve surface to create the ring, and then use the array to array the stones around the ring. I hope you found this helpful and easy to understand. If you have any comments, questions, or feedback for us, definitely let us know in the comments section down below. You can find us on YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter as well, and we would love to hear from you. We'd also love to see what kind of rings you come up with and design. So if you do one, definitely share it with us. Hope that you guys like this. Take care and have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.